Hello, my name is Jill Huang Riquelto, Director of Government Relations and Public Policy at NMAC. I want to welcome you to our first annual Hill Champions Awards presented by Gilead. During these unprecedented times, when Americans in record numbers demanded action on racial justice and an end to the senseless murders at the hands of those empowered to protect us, we in the HIV field evolved to not only end the epidemic, but to identify those among us who are victims of a society that has all too often forgotten them. This year, in addition to Breonna Taylor, George Floyd, and tragically many others, we lost a powerful icon, Congressman John Lewis. Together with the late Congressman Elijah Cummings, they were the voice of racial justice in the halls of Congress. NMAC wanted to honor their memory through the creation of two awards, the Elijah Cummings Award for Minority Health Equality and the John Lewis Good Trouble Award. Today, we will honor two heroes in our movement, Congresswoman Barbara Lee and Speaker Nancy Pelosi. Together, they worked tirelessly with Congressman Lewis and Cummings to ensure that the most powerful institution in the United States, the United States Congress, serves as a check on all forms of discrimination and racial inequalities. We will hear from Dr. Maya Rocky Moore Cummings, Congressman Kwasi Nfume, and Congressman Jim Clyburn. We will also have a special performance courtesy of Broadway Cares. But to kick it all off, please join me in welcoming NMAC's Executive Director for over 30 years, Paul Kawada.
Thank you, Joe, and thank you to everyone who's joined us this afternoon for this very special Hill Champions event. You know, this was NMAC's pivot during these difficult times to try to figure out new ways to raise much needed money. I particularly want to thank staff, the board, and the host committee. They did something that wasn't part of our 2020 work plan. This afternoon, we get to honor two extraordinary women, Speaker Nancy Pelosi and Representative Barbara Lee. Together, we're putting together an event that says thank you to these extraordinary leaders for their work to end the HIV epidemic in America. You will never know how grateful we are for all of your support. Before I end, I would be remiss if I didn't say thank you to Norm Nickens. Norm provided a $10,000 challenge grant. Now, what you need to know is that for organizations like NMAC, and for so many minority organizations, you know, having a donor come forward and say, here's a $10,000 challenge grant, usually never happens. And so to Norm, thank you so much. And to everyone who's joining us, we hope that you will be able to text a donation to NMAC. And thank you so much for all of your support. Have a great event, and I look forward to seeing everyone in person soon.
When the situation seems impossible, you continue to find the strength and defy the odds.
Something has changed within me. Something is not the same. I'm through with playing by the rules of someone else's game. Too late for second guessing. Too late to go back to sleep. It's time to trust my instincts. Close my eyes. And you can't pull me down. comes with much too high a cost. I should abide by you, Valley. Kiss me goodbye, I'm defying gravity, and you can pull me down. Come with me. Unlimited. Together we're unlimited. Together we'll be the greatest team there's ever been. Dreams the way we planned them. If we work in tandem, there's no fight we cannot win. Does it?
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Rafael Gonzalez, and I'm a member of NMAC's Reclaiming Our Place at the Table advocacy group. Since 1993, Congressman Jim Clyburn has served the good people of South Carolina's 6th Congressional District. As the powerful majority House Majority Whip, Congressman Clyburn works tirelessly to ensure the votes for good legislation, such as ending the epidemic, are there. Here to say a few words about his dear friends, Congressman Cummings and Congressman Lewis, the Dean of South Carolina's Congressional Delegation, Congressman Jim Clyburn.
Let me thank you all for giving these awards to two outstanding people, both of whom I've had the great pleasure of serving with. And of course, they're being named in honor of two people who I've had the great honor of serving with. Nancy Pelosi getting the John R. Lewis Award is something that is really worthwhile, not just for her, but for us. John Lewis, with whom I enjoyed a 60-year friendship, greatly admired and respected Nancy Pelosi, and she returned those emotions many, many times over. So I want to congratulate her for getting this award. And I want to congratulate you for awarding it to her. And also want to congratulate Barbara Lee. I've known Barbara Lee for a long, long time. Barbara Lee and I first met back in 1972 when we were both Shirley Chisholm delegates down in Miami, Florida, to the Democratic National Convention. In fact, if you were to check the record, you would see that Shirley Chisholm got two votes from South Carolina in 1972, one from me and one from Dr. Roswell Beck. And when it came time to cast the unanimous vote, we didn't. Our votes are still recorded. for Shirley Chisholm, probably worked in that campaign. And it's what brought her into politics. And it's just a great thing to come to Washington to serve with her. And for her to be getting an award in the name of my good friend, Elijah Cummings. He was a good friend. I often tell people about the time right after Elijah got elected to Congress from Miller, I told Elijah that I wanted to have a homecoming service for him at the church that his family grew up in, Mount Zero Baptist Church, right outside of the little town of Manning in Clarendon County. And when he agreed, he came to the celebration. My wife and I went to the church. On our way there, a terrible storm came up. And it was lightning everywhere, trees were falling, and we just thought that this was just a terrible thing to be having this homecoming for Elijah Cummings, and the weather was going to destroy all of the attendance. That was not the case. When we got to Mount Zero Baptist Church, it was full of people, irrespective of trees falling around them. And Elijah Cummings was honored. And who was it that said, "You can't go home again"? Not true. Elijah did come home again. And well, he and John both have gone on to greater rewards. But all of us are better off that both of them lived. And the two people you're honoring tonight are better. We are better off because they serve.
On April 16, 1996, Maryland witnessed a rising star being sworn in to represent that state's 7th Congressional District. Congressman Elijah Cummings knew what mattered to his constituents. He knew that health care for all, especially those who are in most need, must be provided. That's why he so passionately defended the public option. We all remember the 2016 Democratic National Convention when Congressman Cummings declared, "Our party does not just believe, but understands that Black lives matter." Presenting the Elijah Cummings Award for Minority Health Equality to Congresswoman Barbara Lee is his wife, Dr. Maya Rocky Moore Cummings.
Hello, my name is Dr. Maya Rocky Moore Cummings, and I am super excited to be awarding NMAC's first ever Elijah E. Cummings Award for Minority Health Equality to none other than the fabulous Congresswoman Barbara Lee. Now, to understand how this is so appropriate, I have to take you back to 1998, when I first interviewed Congressman Cummings for my dissertation, which was on the Minority AIDS Initiative being led by Congresswoman Maxine Waters at the time. And I went into the interview with Elijah and I asked him about things like the stigma that was associated with HIV/AIDS. And he said, "This is not about the stigma. I don't care about that. This is about saving lives." And as you all know, Elijah was passionate, a fierce champion and defender of addressing health equity, closing health disparities, and making sure that he was leveraging all of the power that he had in order to improve the lives of those who are most vulnerable amongst us. And Barbara Lee shares that same value. She shares the same passion. It's no mistake that you are awarding this to her and that Elijah and she and I were all friends because she is just a champion for closing health disparities, for making sure that everyone has a quality of life, to make sure that the funding is there, that the champions are there, that the information is there. She is just incredible. And so I just want to say congratulations to Congresswoman Barbara Lee for receiving this award. And I want to thank NMAC and all of his supporters for bestowing this first ever award in Elijah's name. I thank you so much and may God bless.
Thank you. To my dear friend and colleague, Dr. Maya Rocky Moore Cummings, for your warm words and for your friendship. I also thank our whip, Congressman Jim Clyburn, for his tremendous leadership and also for his remarks recounting our long history of serving together beginning in 1972 as Shirley Chisholm delegates and, of course, our partnership, work with, and our love for the Honorable Elijah Cummings and the Honorable John Lewis. I am so pleased to join NMAC and all of you for the Hill Champions Awards on World AIDS Day 2020. We have come together for 33 years to mark and remember the lives we have lost and the progress we have made. Thank you to Paul Kawata, Executive Director of NMAC, and John Hill, Chairman of the Board of NMAC, for your tireless commitment to work towards an AIDS-free generation. In recognition of World AIDS Day, my fellow HIV/AIDS Caucus co-chair, Congresswoman Jennifer Gonzalez-Colon, we recently introduced the House resolution supporting the goals of World AIDS Day. I am so pleased to congratulate the greatest speaker ever, my friend and colleague, Speaker Nancy Pelosi, who will receive the John Lewis Good Trouble Award later in the program, presented by my colleague and friend, Congressman Kwaisi Mfume. In the face of a deeply polarized Congress, Speaker Pelosi has continued to lead the House to pass and prioritize policies that uplift everyone. She has maintained her decades of commitment to govern for the greater good, and she's also gotten into a fair share of good trouble along the way. I am so honored to accept NMAC's first ever Elijah Cummings Award for Minority Health Equity. What an honor. As Dr. Maya Rockymore Cummings mentioned earlier, Elijah Cummings was a fierce champion of defending and addressing health equity. It's been my greatest honor to join Elijah Cummings in his work to close health disparities, to improve and save the lives of the most vulnerable nationally and globally. My very first visit outside of my district was to see the good work of HIV/AIDS activists and clinics and healthcare providers with Elijah in a Congressional Black Caucus tour to his beloved district of Baltimore. When I was first elected, Elijah came to my district as my guest at a criminal justice forum. His presence in my community excited everyone, and then they believed I really was a member of Congress. And yes, I will be forever grateful for his early support and his confidence in me. I will cherish this award and honor his legacy by trying to continue to live up to his ideals, and yes, to continue our fight for justice in his honor, in his name. The devastation of COVID-19 reminds us that access to healthcare is not yet equal. As the co-founder and co-chair of the bipartisan Congressional HIV/AIDS Caucus and as vice chair of the State and Foreign Operations Subcommittee on Appropriations, I will continue to lead and defend our work to end the HIV epidemic. And I look forward to working with you and to working with my colleagues to continue Elijah's legacy. Thank you again to NMAC for establishing the Elijah Cummings Award for Minority Health Equality to honor his legacy. I look forward to continuing our decades of progress with you because we will achieve an AIDS-free generation by 2030 in the name of our beloved Elijah Cummings. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. My name is Warren Alexander O'Meara Dates. I am from the state of Alabama and a person living with HIV, a member of NMAC's Reclaiming Our Place at the Table cohort. In February 1996, Congressman Kwasi Mfume left the U.S. House of Representatives to accept the presidency of the NAACP, stating that, quote, he could do no more to improve American civil rights there than in Congress, end quote. His passion for fighting for federal funding for inner cities drives his desire each and every day as a member of Congress, a seat previously held by Congressman Elijah Cummings. Presenting the John Lewis Good Trouble Award to Speaker Nancy Pelosi, please join me in welcoming Congressman Kwasi Mfume.
Hi, I'm Congressman Kwasi Mfume, representing Maryland's 7th Congressional District, and I'm honored to join you this evening to present NMAC's first ever John Lewis Good Trouble Award to House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. But before I present the award to the Speaker, let me first say a few words about my friend and her friend, the late Congressman John Lewis. John and I met in 1986 as young guys running for the Congress. He was in Atlanta, I was in Baltimore, and we were both underdogs in our respective races. He was running against a highly favored state senator, and I was running against a highly favored state senator. Well, lo and behold, the highly favored state senators didn't win, and John and I did. And we stood on the floor of the House in January of the following year to take the oath of office. Ironically, Nancy Pelosi stood there just 6 months later as she was also sworn in to the 100th Congress of the United States. And John and I just started a friendship there that went on for many, many years. He and his late wife Lillian and the rest of his family and everyone else grabbed all of us together as a class and kept us together as best they could, both on the floor and off the floor, so that we got to know each other, learn each other, and love each other. So we miss John, and we all believe that he just left us too soon. So I'm honored here tonight to talk about this award, particularly in his honor, and particularly because it's going to our speaker. For more than 30 years, NMAC, formerly known as the National Minority AIDS Council, has fought to reduce health disparities across our nation. In partnership with Congressman John Lewis, the late Congressman Elijah Cummings, and many other civil rights champions, NMAC has worked to ensure HIV therapeutics are available to all patients, especially those from marginalized communities. So whether we're talking about life expectancy, infant mortality, or HIV rates, we know that social justice is a public health issue, which is why I was very happy to see NMAC incorporate a social justice platform into this year's conference. And to that end, I can't think of a better advocate to receive the first Good Trouble Award than Speaker of the House, Nancy Pelosi. Like Congressman John Lewis, Speaker Pelosi has dedicated her entire life to civil rights. She championed the Affordable Care Act and has fought to ensure communities of color get equal access to life-saving drugs. Nancy Pelosi understands that Black Lives Matter is more than just a slogan. It is indeed a call to action. She's fought to dismantle racist policies and attack systemic racism at its root. And like our friend, Congressman John Lewis, Speaker Pelosi believes getting into trouble, especially when it's good trouble, is a good thing. And so it's been a pleasure for me to serve alongside her as we work with so many others to help make this country a more perfect union. And it is indeed my high honor on this World AIDS Day to present this award to my friend, our Speaker of the House, Nancy D'Alessandro Pelosi.
Thank you, my dear friend, Congressman Kwasi Mfume, for your kind words. It is a privilege to send warm greetings to Paul Kawada and the brilliant leaders at MX Hill Champions virtual event. It is also a joy to join you in recognizing a true Hill champion, my dear friend and colleague from across the bay, Congresswoman Barbara Lee, as she receives the Elijah Cummings Award for Minority Health Equity. Since her first day in Congress, Barbara Lee has been a tireless leader on HIV/AIDS and worked alongside Elijah in his lifelong mission to expand healthcare access for all, regardless of race, gender, or socioeconomic condition. Congratulations, Barbara. Since 1987, NMAC's courageous leadership has been essential to ending the scourge of HIV/AIDS and now to combating the forces of racial, economic, health, and social injustice that undermine our communities. That is why I am so honored to accept NMAC's first ever John Lewis Good Trouble Award. John was the conscience of the Congress, a trailblazer of our history, and an inspiration to all Americans. His life and work symbolized the triumph of freedom over fear, hope over hate. John reminded us all how important good trouble, necessary trouble, is in the fight for justice and opportunity. In everything he did throughout his life, John worked on the side of the angels, and now he is with them. On behalf of the United States Congress, thank you, NMAC, for establishing this award in John's honor and for continuing his lifelong work to advance a brighter, more just, and equal future for all. Thank you again for this wonderful honor and for your ongoing partnership in this vital mission.
Good evening. My name is Robert York, Director of Development here at NMAC, where
We lead with race. We'd like to say thank you for attending tonight's inaugural event for the Hill Champion Awards. We'd also like to say thank you to Congressman Clyburn, Congressman Mfume, and again, congratulations to Representative Lee and Speaker Pelosi. And now a special thanks to our sponsors, Gilead, Merck, Planned Parenthood, and our amazing host committee that made tonight possible. If you're able to donate, please text NMAC to 50155. Again, that's texting NMAC to 50155. And now it gives me great pleasure and pride to introduce the closing video, which is a call to action called But I Survived. It's time for us to stand with our trans men and women around the country, specifically within our communities, because trans lives matter, Black trans lives matter. We have so much work left to do, and we're here to work with you to make a difference.
Took what you gave, but you never noticed that I was in vain. I knew what I wanted, I went on and got it. Did all the things that you said that I